In this video, I will be conducting hypothesis Z tests for one sample mean in R for two-tailed and one-tailed tests. Let's first consider these two-tailed tests. The null hypothesis states that the population mean is equal to 7, while the alternative hypothesis states that the mean is not equal to 7. It is two-tailed because not equal to 7 could mean greater than 7 or less than 7. Note that I've moved my console from the bottom left to the top right here. Now, suppose we select a sample and obtain a sample mean x bar of 7.8. I'm going to separate with a semicolon. Suppose the standard deviation is 2.7. Separate again with a semicolon, and the sample size n is 35. The hypothesized mean mu is 7. To perform the z-test, we need to calculate the test statistic using the following formula. Z equals x bar minus mu divided by standard deviation divided by the square root of n. I'll type z again here to display its value. I'll select all the statements and click run. You can see the z value here as 1.75. Next, I'll compute the p value, the probability of obtaining a test statistic as extreme or more extreme than this 1.75 we obtained, assuming the null hypothesis is true. The p-value will be the area in the tails of the test statistic. We will use the pnum function, which by default produces the area below a z-score. On running it, we have the less than area of about 0.96. However, we want the area in the right tail since the z-value is positive. That greater than area will be 1 minus this less than area. Since this is a two-tailed test, the p-value will be 2 times that area in the tail, which gives 0.0796. Now, typically, we reject the null hypothesis if the p-value is less than the specified significance level alpha for the test. Let's assume alpha is 0.05. Since this p-value is greater than alpha, we will fail to reject the null hypothesis at alpha equals 0.05. In other words, the result is not significant. Note that the result will be significant at an alpha of 0.1, since this p-value is less than 0.1. Now, suppose we decide to use the critical value or region approach for significance at alpha equals 0.05. We can use the qnum function to obtain the z-critical values. We will use qnum 0.05 over 2 to divide the alpha value into the two tails. On running that, we have negative 1.96 for the lower tail. Because the normal curve is symmetric, it will be positive 1.96 for the upper tail. This means, using the critical value approach, we should reject the null hypothesis at alpha equals 0.05 if our z-stat is less than negative 1.96 or if it is greater than positive 1.96. Since this z-stat is not in the critical region, we do not reject the null hypothesis and the decision is consistent with the decision using p-value approach. Next, suppose this were a right-tailed or upper-tailed test where the alternative hypothesis is mu greater than 7. The test statistic will be the same, but the p-value will only be in the right tail and not multiplied by 2. On running that, we obtain a p-value of 0.0398 for the upper-tailed test. Now, that p-value is less than an alpha of 0.05, indicating that we should reject the null hypothesis at alpha equals 0.05. That is, the result is significant. But if alpha had been 0.01, we would have failed to reject the null hypothesis since the p-value is greater than 0.01. For the critical value approach, alpha will only be in the right tail, since this is a right-tailed test. The qnum function primarily takes a less than area, so we will use 1 minus 0.05 to obtain a positive critical value. All we could do, negative qnum 0.05. Running that, we have a critical value of 1.645. That is, for the right-tailed test, the result is significant if our z-statistic is greater than 1.645. Since a z-statistic of 1.75 is greater than this critical value of 1.645, we will again reject the null hypothesis. Finally, suppose this were a left or lower-tailed test, where we're testing if the population mean is less than 7. Suppose the sample mean x bar is now 5.9. I'm going to rerun lines 6 to 9. You can see that we now have a z value of negative 2.41. Since this is a lower tail test, the p-value can be found by simply taking p-num z. Running that results in a lower tail area of 0.008, which is the p-value for the test. Since this p-value is less than 0.05, we will reject the null hypothesis and say that the result is significant in this case as well. Note that if alpha were 0.01, the result will still be significant, since this p-value is still less than 0.01. For the critical region approach, suppose alpha equals 0.01, we will simply use qnum 0.01 since this is a lower tail test. Running that gives a z-critical value of negative 2.33. That is, the result is significant if the z-stat is less than negative 2.33. Since the z-stat is less than negative 2.33, we again reject the null hypothesis at alpha equals 0.01 and say that the result is significant. And that's it for this video. Thanks for watching.